Hey everyone, Steve Patterson here from PhotoshopEssentials.com. In this video, I'll show you some great tips and tricks you can use with the crop tool when cropping images in Photoshop. You'll learn time-saving keyboard shortcuts, a few ways to customize the crop tool, and even how to use the crop tool to quickly add a border around your image. If you're new to Photoshop and not sure how to crop images, be sure to check out my previous video where I cover the basics. I'll be using Photoshop CC, but everything here is fully compatible with Photoshop CS6. Let's get started. Here's the image I'll be using. I downloaded this one from Adobe Stock. So let's start with the crop tool's keyboard shortcuts. To select the crop tool, rather than grabbing it from the toolbar, just tap the letter C on your keyboard. As you're resizing the crop border, you can lock the aspect ratio by holding down your Shift key as you drag a corner handle. To resize the border from its center, press and hold Alt or Option on a Mac while dragging a handle. And to both lock the aspect ratio and resize the border from its center, hold Shift-Alt or Shift-Option on a Mac and drag one of the corners. To swap the orientation of the crop border between portrait and landscape, press the letter X. If you want to hide the area outside the crop border to get a better sense of what the cropped version will look like, press H. Then press H again to bring the cropped area back. By default, when we click and drag inside the crop border, we move the image around inside it while the border stays in place. To move the border, not the image, you can switch to classic mode by pressing the letter P. Then drag to move the border around inside the image. Press P again to return to the default mode. If you need to straighten your image, you can temporarily access the Straighten tool by pressing and holding Ctrl or Command on a Mac while the Crop tool is active. Drag across something that should be straight, either vertically or horizontally, and then release your mouse button to rotate the image. Once you've straightened the image, release your Ctrl or Command key to switch back to the Crop tool. To cancel the crop, press the Escape key on your keyboard. Let's look at a couple of tips to use with the crop overlay that appears inside the border. By default, Photoshop displays the rule of thirds overlay, which can help with our composition. But if you click the overlay icon in the options bar, you'll see that there are different overlays to choose from. To quickly cycle through them from your keyboard, press the letter O. Also by default, Photoshop displays the overlay at all times, even when you're not resizing the crop border. But if you click the overlay icon, you'll find a couple of other display options to choose from. If you choose Auto Show Overlay, then Photoshop will only display the overlay while you're actually adjusting the border, which makes it easier to see your image. And choosing Never Show Overlay prevents the overlay from appearing at all. To switch back to the default mode, choose Always Show Overlay from the list. When you're ready to crop your image, press Enter or Return on your keyboard, or you can double-click inside the crop border. And if you need to undo the crop, press Ctrl-Z or Command-Z on a Mac. And finally, the crop tool isn't just for cropping images, it can also be used to add more canvas space around the image, giving us an easy way to add a border. If we look in the Layers panel, we see my image on the background layer. To keep the border separate from the image, it's a good idea to duplicate the image first. To do that from your keyboard, press Ctrl-J or Command-J on a Mac. A copy of the image appears above the original. Photoshop will fill the new canvas space with your current background color, which by default is white. Select the crop tool either from the toolbar or by pressing the letter C. And in the options bar, make sure that the Delete Cropped Pixels option is turned on. Then, drag the handles away from the image to add more canvas space. Hold Alt or Option on a Mac as you drag to resize the canvas from its center. As you do, you'll see Photoshop filling the extra space with your background color. To accept it, press Enter or Return on a Mac. And there we have it! That's some tips and tricks you can use with the crop tool the next time you're cropping images in Photoshop. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please consider liking it, sharing it, and subscribing to our channel. Visit our website, PhotoshopEssentials.com, for more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm Steve Patterson from PhotoshopEssentials.com.